Superintendent's report.
Well, we didn't have any attendance meetings this month because we've not been in school since March the 13th. But we are preparing, as I said earlier, to do the March ADM report. And we look for our enrollment to be around 965. So we will let you know about that. We were moving in the right direction with getting students to understand they needed to come to school on a regular basis and why it was important to academic progress. But we'll just have to start over again when we start another school year. So that was attendance. And for the COVID-19, on your table, I have given everybody a packet that has, well, two things actually. One shows you what our website looks like for COVID-19. And there is an actual, and yours is not in color, but you have something that shows our website. And then if you flip to the second page and you flip to the third page, there is a COVID-19 section, a COVID-19 updates on our front of our website. And if you go to the bottom of page 3, you see COVID-19 updates, and then there are quick links that show you how to get to the schools. On the last page, that didn't come out very clearly, but you can keep clicking and find our COVID-19 page, which has all of the documents that you have in this bigger document. So what I've done is printed out everything that's on that web page about what Edgemont Primary School's continuity of learning looks like, what Jeter Watson's continuity of learning looks like, and then the Covington High School has every course listed again, 51 some courses listed about what they're doing and how they're doing it. The principals have put together outstanding documents on how families need to understand what we're doing and how we're doing it. The CHS departments have conference. They have office hours, like Mr. Groot has office hours from 1 to 2 p.m. Monday through Friday. Mr. Wood has office hours 12:30 to 1:30 on Monday through Friday. And there's conference calling numbers and PIN numbers for families to call in, or kids to call in and speak to the teachers. Each teacher has listed what they're teaching this semester, what they need the families to know, and when they'll be available to talk to the students. Edgemont and Jeter have times that they're supposed to call or check their emails at different times of the day so the families know that they are taking care of their children. And we have some information in there about grades. So this is a very comprehensive packet about what the schools are doing to provide instructional support. And I have to thank Dr. Furman and all the principals for what they've put together since last Monday afternoon, because last Monday afternoon, we weren't sure if we could pull this off this quickly, but they did. And there's still some things that need to be fine-tuned, but for the most part, our students have what they need. We're providing phone calls back to families when they're not sure how to do something. And you just have to trust us that we are doing what we should be doing. And it's not like being in school every day, but it's the best that we can do at the moment. So I'm just very proud of this document, and I'm very proud of the principals and the teachers who have put this together in this short amount of time. So, and I gave you all a copy of that. And if you have questions after you take it, it's hot off the press this afternoon, please call us or call Dr. Furman, read through it. It is on our website for families to access, and we will be doing calls to families to let them know where it is and how we can provide support. And we have set up three different websites or emails account, epsinfo@covington.k12, jwisinfo@covington.k12.va.us, chs And then one here for the school board, and principals are monitoring that all the time to see if there's something a family needs, if they can get someone to answer the phone, because staff is in and out. We are responding to those emails of families. And if they call here, they can't get, don't have an email, we will call the principals to get them some support. We don't want any child or family, it is a stressful time for families. And we know that some of them are still trying to work and keep their family safe and secure, and then they've just had one added burden to educate their children. We appreciate what they're doing to help us out. So it's a joint effort again with our families. The response to our families on Thursday pickup day, Edgemont has only 3 families they have not heard from. Mr. Bennett has 20 some families that he did not either connect with or hasn't come by. I think he's going to take the school bus out the end of this week or the first of next week and go home, go by each home and drop off the materials. Mr. Cantrell and Mr. Jones and their staff are still having office hours, and they're still down there waiting for children if they need an assistance, and they're still working hard to get every family connected with what they need. So it's just been an outstanding effort by everyone. So that's all I have to talk about with COVID-19, and just pray that everyone's safe, yes, and healthy, and yes, we are all okay and when this is all behind us.
Okay, thank you, Melinda. I know last time you mentioned something about hot spots. Is that disclosed in here as
well?
Yes,
there is something in here somewhere about hot spots. We have Chromebooks available at the high school, and Mr. Cantrell and Mr. Burkholder and Mr. Jones are passing out Chromebooks and also hot spots to families that don't have that connection. So we have been reaching out to lots of families to provide that support. And if you know of someone that won't call and tell us, we will call them. So just give us a name.
Okay.
But we think we've got everyone covered.
Okay. All right. Any comments? Anybody?
I just wanted to say something about the teachers, sorry.
Just the whole staff in general have just went over and beyond. I've been looking at the Facebook, and teachers are reading the books, and just so many different creative things that they come up with, and I'm just proud of them.
Yes.
Because this is something none of us have ever
experienced
or happened even slightly.
Right, it is amazing what they've been able to do in a short amount of time.
Yes.
In a very short amount of time.
Mm-hmm.
In less than a month, we've done two different, completely turnaround, two different events to keep our students learning. So
definitely.
It's really true, and I think what needs to be stated is that the staff, I mean the service workers and the instructional staff, they're doing this all while the guidelines seem to get more and more and more and more restrictive.
Yes.
And they continue to go out there, and you know, you hear about the healthcare workers, but you don't hear about the school people.
Definitely.
That are out there putting their lives at risk as well.
Definitely.
Yeah.
And they are. Everybody. It takes a community.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Responders.
Like you said, taking lunches to families.
Yeah.
I know I took packets. Everybody.
Yeah.
And on top of that, we got a new student that the police department helped with.
Yeah.
So
that's
good too.
Yeah.
Okay. If there's no comments, we have
executive session.
Executive session.
Yes.
Okay, anybody?